will just quickly introduce Anna-Liisa. Anna-Liisa Laine leads a research program investigating the complex web of interactions that link species to one another in nature, and she has been a strong advocate for how our understanding of biodiversity can be used to develop a sustainable future, and continue on the interesting subject.
All right. Thank you, Lisa, for the introduction, and Jussi for the excellent introduction to the TWINWIN experiment. So the whole experiment was founded on the idea that there are principles in biodiversity science that perhaps we could utilize to guide sustainable agriculture. And this is what the TWINWIN team has been working towards. And today I want to tell you about some of the preliminary results that we have. And this is very much a team effort. And in particular, the results that I'll tell you about today have been led by postdoctoral researchers, Dr. Seraina Cappelli and Dr. Luis Domegnos Horta. In biodiversity science, there's a concept of the BEF relationship, and that predicts that higher levels of biodiversity should promote desired ecosystem functions. And these functions include productivity and yield of ecosystems and their stress tolerance. And it can be tolerance against both abiotic and biotic factors, such as drought and disease. And for a long time, it had a strong theoretical foundation, but less empirical support. But in recent years, we've really seen a surge of biodiversity research. And we're seeing that, indeed, the theory does seem to be holding both under experimental conditions in the lab and in field under manipulated experimental conditions. The higher the levels of diversity in an ecosystem, the higher the ecosystem functions. And what's really promising is that we see that the ecosystem function seems to be highly responsive even to relatively small additions of diversity. And this is, of course, great news for agricultural systems, where plant diversity is mainly under strict human control. And it means that perhaps even the addition of one or two species into the agricultural ecosystem could have positive impacts on the sustainable functioning of these food production systems. The idea is that there are mechanisms that operate above ground that promote this relationship, and we understand a little bit of these. But in recent years, there's increasing interest in, could some of the mechanisms be also mediated by below ground responses? Can higher diversity of plants promote higher diversity of microorganisms in the soil, thereby promoting their interactions that then promote soil decomposition, increases soil organic matter, and ultimately increases carbon storage in the soils? Well, we started out with the above ground processes, which are easier and faster to observe. And we started by testing the disease dilution hypothesis, which predicts that the higher the diversity of host species in a community, the lower the disease risk of an individual. And we observed these plots in the TWINWIN experiment several times during the growing season for disease symptoms. And we often see symptoms of the barley net blotch disease. And we find that there's quite a bit of variation in disease severity among the plots. And we see that, as predicted by theory, we see the lowest levels of disease severity in the high-level diversity plots. We also see a lot of variation among the plots in this trend. Interestingly, the highest level of variation is in those plots that only have one of the underzone species. And this indicates to us that these species differ considerably in the service that they provide to the ecosystem. Some are quite efficient in diluting the disease risk, while others do very little to the community. And again, this is great news for agriculture. It means that the addition of one species into the system can have a positive impact. You just have to be very careful about which species you plug in. What do we know about processes operating below ground? It has become evident in the earlier talks that many of the processes that promote healthy soils are very slow, including carbon sequestration and carbon storage. But there are some others that are much faster. And the one that we've been focusing on currently is the carbon use efficiency of soil microbial communities. And when we set up the experiment, we set it up with the expectation that higher plant diversity would promote higher diversity in microbial communities and hence could promote increased ecosystem functions below ground. And indeed, we find that the soil microbial communities across these different diversity plots vary drastically. They vary both in their diversity and they vary in their structure. Here I'm showing you a plot of cohesion, which is essentially connectivity of the bacterial communities, and we see that with increasing connectivity among the bacteria, we see a reduction in carbon use efficiency. And this could be indicative of antagonistic competitive interactions within the community. We also see that what we see above ground does predict carbon use efficiency below ground. So the higher the cover of barley in these plots, the lower the carbon use efficiency. And of course, barley cover is high when there's little less diversity in the plot. But overall, already in this short time, we've demonstrated that we can manipulate plant diversity in a way that drives the ecosystem towards functions that are desired of sustainable agricultural systems. And I want to thank the entire TWINWIN team and our funders, Nessling Foundation and the Academy of Finland. Thank you.